Today I'm going to show you probably one of the biggest and best mail days I'll ever have. Stay to the end of the video, please, because you're not going to want to miss it. Let's go. Yo, what up? Army ATC 22 coming back at you. All right, it's been a while since I posted a video, over a week. So what have I been doing, right? I didn't really get to post really on it last time, but the Virginia Beach Fieldhouse show that was on the 19th of August was a really good show. Didn't really get a lot of footage. I posted some stuff on Instagram. Again, if you are not subscribed to me on Instagram, TikTok, all the places, please go do it. It's a lot easier to post on Instagram than it is anywhere else. So I really, really, really like that platform. And I do a lot of content on there and sharing and stuff like that. It's just so much easier. All right. So the Fieldhouse show was great, right? A lot of individuals, a lot of foot traffic, moved some bigger things into some other stuff. So I was pretty, pretty happy. During this time since I've made a video, of course, I made a comment on the fallout of the NFLPA with Panini. Panini then came back, vice versa. Then all of a sudden, Leaf, Brian Gray stepped down. They announced to the new individual. And all in while, Panini's still popping out products left and right. It's nuts. Whatnot started a new policy with, you know, not be able to do certain games and everything. And prize-based type games, a lot of the platform kind of was going that route. It seemed like Whatnot was getting a lot of slack for it because it was a good way for streamers and stuff to make a lot of money off of certain individuals, you know, degens, I would say, and stuff. So they stopped all that, and I believe a lot of the Whatnot streamers are trying to find other ways to get around that. So yesterday I did an interview with DA Car World's The Chase with Troy and David, had me on for the show. Link will be below for the main one. If you go to DA Car World's The Chase, I think they broke it up to another section with just me and everything. But the whole process of them, they talk about Bronny James's new card, you know, coming out from McDonald's, you know, what's going to happen with him, you know, with the recent illnesses and he's had and everything else like that. You know, the cards are coming out in the McDonald's All-American games, but, you know, how much is he going to be playing? Is he, you know, going to eventually make it to the NBA? We'll never know, right? The Prince, is he going to meet the King up there? But I had a great conversation. We were talking about, you know, of course, the logo man that I pulled. You know, they showed the clip and everything that I have on YouTube. And like evolution of group breaks. Talking about back when, you know, I discussed back when, you know, we hosted group breaks here on YouTube the way it was and how it's completely different than today. How then it, you know, transferred into Blog TV and then Breakers and then just kept going and going and going. Right? All these platforms that we have. And we even went into talking about, you know, what brought them into Fanatics and how do I feel that is going to be for the hobby. And as long as the customers, us, the collectors, are we are taken care of, we are not, hopefully not taken advantage of, it will all be good. I've always said group breaks are the best way to get into a box that you can't afford yourself. That's why I was hosting myself and possibly eventually in the future doing it again, baby. But, you know, I explained, like, we did group breaks back in the day for fun. We did it because we wanted to get into a box of cards that was majorly expensive. We couldn't afford it by ourselves. We didn't do it for a profit. All of us. This was how much we paid for a box. Split it. Here's shipping. If you don't get anything, you're not going to get charged shipping. I explained that's how it was back in the day, you know, and it's still some people kind of do that. There are break, you know, groups that still do that stuff. So keep a lookout within the year. Army ATC 22 bringing back the at cost break for fun. Where? I don't know. Probably won't be on Whatnot. Probably won't be on any of them, you know, features. Might be on Instagram. Might be on YouTube again still, right? Going live and everything. So we'll see. But I really, really appreciate Troy and David having me on, the discussions we had and everything. So if you guys go to them, subscribe. They're on Twitch Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Great content. They're great guys. And then they're also, you know, coming in and out, you know, breaking with DA Car World. So again, thank you guys. Hopefully I'll be able to be on there again soon and even meet you guys and, you know, again in the future, because I met them at the National. But yeah, so that was, you know, what's been happening, right? So let's get into some mail days. Yeah. First off, how about the shirt? So this is the Grunt style, right? Ludic shirt. Signatures for Soldiers. It was at the National. I mean, well, they had it started at the Nationals towards, you know, the National charity and stuff like that. Ended up getting one for sure. Had to. This shirt's great. It feels so good. Grunt style shirts are freaking incredible. Some of them, yeah, they are expensive, but it's a Veno company. Being a vet, you know, I had to get one for sure. I love it. This shirt's great. The messed up part about it, I came yesterday, and today, Tim, you know, the founder of Singers for Soldiers, said he's closing down Singers for Soldiers for the foreseeable future. He is down in Florida, got hit with the major hurricane, majorly flooded. Originally, he just closed the doors temporarily because, you know, trying to take care of your family first, everyone, no matter what's going on around, take care of your family first. So he wanted to do that, but I think he made a decision, like, it's just too hard dealing with everything. So he's closing for the foreseeable future. I know a lot of people are behind him. Tim, I hope we see you again in the future. Hopefully I can help in some way. I'd like to be involved with Signature for Soldiers if you bring it back. I didn't get to really talk to you at the National about it. I was, you know, every which way, running all over the place. I met you. I did meet you last year. Thanks, Hudson Fan. You know, Tom, to introducing us, but I'd like to get involved more with that if you come back and everything. And if not, maybe I'll start something myself. Who knows? But yeah, so that was the mail day, first mail day that came in. Next, we'll start off with a couple others. So, of course, like I said, with Whatnot breaking away from the games and, hey, if you hit this, you win this type of thing. A lot of the streamers were going to town with different products and stuff trying to do it. And, of course, I got into some. I like to gamble, right? I like to deal with that stuff. And when I found ones that were reasonably priced to do stuff, I had to hop in. So I got into one. The first one I got into was a guy that was breaking Bowman U football. And he was, if you hit a Bryce Young auto out of 150 or less, you won, like, it was like $5,000 worth of product or whatever, right? So I got a few packs, super cheap, like, I mean, cheap, almost as cheap as it is for the packs, you know? Some of these streamers were selling packs for outrageous price, and I'll talk to you about it in one of these other ones I got. But ended up getting a few packs. Oh, one and done. Didn't hit a Bryce Young auto, but I did hit a Hendon Hooker. Let's see if it, yeah. Hendon Hooker orange, 25/25, the prime signatures auto. Pretty sweet. So I was pretty happy about that. I found another, God, I can't remember. Again, this is where I've said, put stickers, put something, showing your company inside your products, and I'll be able to promote you online, right? Another one, I can't remember who it was. I think it's Bleacher. It was Bleacher Breaks. I'm almost positive. One of them. They were doing basketball, trying to hit a Wemby. If you hit a Wemby numbered autograph, I think it was, you won, again, craziness. Tons of wax and everything. And apparently some people have hit those. So I ended up getting some packs, and I think one box, I got some stuff, and these are the three bigger hits that I hit from him. I hit some autos. I hit a red auto out of 10, someone that's just going to sit in here because he's not even in the league yet, still in college. But first, I got the big O, Oscar. These are the Constellations of Greatness. This is the super short print. I believe this is the case hits, one of the case hits from Bowman Best U. I've said one of the best products for basketball is college because they have live Wemby autos. But yeah, that. And then I actually hit the girl that follows me everywhere, Caitlin Clark. Also Constellations of Greatness. I'm sure Patrick, aka RVA Collectibles, is gonna want this because he wants everything Caitlin Clark. Everything female, actually basketball related. And then, out of nowhere, the Super Fractor colors came up. Let's see if we get it. End up hitting a Roddy Gale Jr., Ohio State, High of Fate. Sorry, Ryan. Super Fractor 101 auto. I mean, not an auto, 101. Pretty sweet. I don't know if it's gonna show up, because I have it on cinematic mode, so it's trying to focus on everything, but 101 Super, nice. So can't beat that. Again, the gamble is there. A lot of people weren't hitting, and I ended up hitting some stuff that actually got my money back and some. But these right here are the ones is the moneymaker. A guy was doing the same thing with one box, I might've been multiple boxes of Optic Football Retail, right? He didn't tell people it's retail. I knew because I saw the Blue Stars parallels coming out. And it was pick your player. You open the pack, you won the pack, you open the pack, and if you hit the player, you got a guaranteed Downtown or Kaboom, okay? They had their own mystery packs that have Downtown and Kabooms. All you do is pick a player and you won one. People were not buying the packs. They had them super priced, right? Listen, we know how much a retail box of Optic is. You're trying to sell these for $25 a pop. That's what Whatnot was stopping it for, right? Yes, you're trying to get your cost back of the mystery packs and stuff that you have with the Kabooms and Downtowns in, but you have to figure another way to get it lower. So people weren't buying. I ended up, he put out a, all right, I'm gonna start a dollar auction. This one's for three packs. Not for one, for three packs. I ended up winning this for, I believe, $19 for three packs of Optic Retail. Optic Retail, I'm going for the gusto, right? So again, knowing when you deal with these type of gambles and stuff, I always say know the players and know what they have in the product. All right, so knowing Optic has a million different inserts on top of just a regular base and stuff, I knew I had to go with a rookie. I mean, everyone want it, people were just telling me left and right, go for T-Law, go for this, whatever. I was like, I gotta go for a rookie because they have more than just their rookie cards in it. They have everything. So I ended up going with Ritter. It seems like Ritter comes out of everything, and I ended up hitting one of these legendary logos, which are actually shorter print, right? You know, the prism variation. So it's sweet. So I got to win one of the downtowns. And it ended up hitting, sucks who the player is, Jameson Williams, downtown rookie from Optic in the mystery bet. I believe he's out for the season now, if I'm not mistaken, because he got hurt even more. I can't remember something about him, I think. So sweet, that was like literally the first pack. Ritter came out, I was so happy. So I had still two packs left. And the second pack, nothing came out. But then the third pack, how about a Blue Stars Ritter comes out, which this is actually a better card too. Looks pretty good also. And he's like, holy crap, I've never had this before. It's usually like one per customer. But he gave me another one of the mystery packs. And it was another downtown of Davante Adams. So this is where the gamble paid off. $19. Bingo, bango, bongo. Pretty much got these for free. And these will probably go for more than 19. I don't even know. So if you do get yourself in one of those predicaments where that type of stuff's available for you, be cognizant, because you can go too far, right? Just like scratch offs, everything else. Just you, if you don't stop yourself, you don't whatever, you can go too far. Like it's crazy. So let's move on. Let's get to some other things before the rest of the mail days. So where am I going to be over the next few weeks, right? This weekend's Labor Day. Everyone stay safe. If you're not working, you know, everyone's gonna be barbecuing, finishing up, you know, it's supposed to be the end of summer, but people are already back at school, whatever. Be safe, right? This weekend, not really doing anything, staying around the house. We are helping some friends move and everything else. Like, I'm putting some stuff together. But next weekend, next Saturday, I am going to be set up at the new Short Pump Show hosted by Tidewater Cards. Look it up. I have it on my Instagram. But look up Tidewater Cards and Collectibles. Going to be over 70 plus tables. First time there. In a huge shopping type of area. Going to be tons of foot traffic. Going to be a great time. The weekend after that, September 16th, I will be in Alexandria, Virginia. I'm going to try to post it. Let's see if I can do this correctly. Boop. Right there. Denny's Cards. If I don't put it here, it's going to be so funny because it's just pointing at air. But Denny's Cards is hosting a trade night in Alexandria, Virginia. I will be there. I'm bringing Mac collection from down here in Richmond. I'm trying to get a lot of people from the Richmond area, from the Virginia Beach area, to come up that way. He doesn't want people to drive to this trade. No, we're going to come. There is no big card show that weekend. Nothing. Let's go. People, come on in. Let's go. Let's go see. Let's give Denny Cards, who is on Instagram, podcast, everything, just getting big in the hobby. So if you're not following him, follow him, please. Going to his show, going to his trade night, supporting him. It's free entry. The place is pretty much letting us be there for free. All they're asking for is all the food and every money that goes into, you know, they're going to have food for sale there, is all going to that nonprofit for the location. So hopefully I have it up in this corner. If I don't, I look like a moron over here pointing at it. But that would be the next few weeks. So let's continue on with the mail days. This next one, I got in a group break, Cardinals, of course, right? For some guys down in the Virginia Beach area, Newport News area, and ended up getting the Pat Tillman out of 35. I think this is the gold parallel base. So it's pretty sweet. And now I have this one. I have the out of 40, which is the jersey number parallel, and then the out of 99. So I have three of them. Missed the out of 25 that was damaged and sold for super cheap. So mad. I forgot that I had it on eBay, and I just didn't do it. But this next piece is incredible. Shout out to Michael Thomas on Instagram. I posted everything on there. Go to there, follow him, everything else. He sent me this incredible piece. If you're following Card Collector 2, Ryan, Santiago Sports, Tyler, Mojo J, you know, and AO, he posted on Instagram. Michael sent these to him too. He had a local friend that painted these. They're like McFarlane figures. Look at this nastiness. Like, I posted a really good picture on Instagram, but this detail is sick. It's incredible. So Tyler, Santiago Sports, actually in his green area, because he got Corey Sligiger, he got him to sign it, so it's pretty sweet. Of course, I'm not going to be able to have Pat Tillman sign mine. But Mojo, Jay, and got a DeMarcus Cousins. It's pretty sick. Ryan ended up getting Ohio State. Legend, one of his big PCs. But, dude, this is incredible. I can't thank you enough. I'm going to get you back for sure. This is sick. And reached out to the actual guy that does these, and he gave me a quote. I'm gonna get a Dan Marino done, so have them sitting right next to each other. Gonna be sick, right? Actually, not that expensive, surprisingly. But yeah. So I appreciate you guys watching this whole time, but I'm not done yet. I told you stay to the end because I have a crazy, crazy, crazy mail day. Probably one of the biggest I've ever had. And I'm gonna show you why, and you're gonna know why, kind of just by the name. So today I got in the mail something, my first time ever buying from Golden Auctions. I actually reached out to Ken Golden after I won this auction and said, thank you for the platform. You know, I would probably would never be able to have the opportunity to get this. Yeah, it's crazy, right? So to preempt, you know, the actual item, on Facebook, I was tagged multiple times in a Facebook group, and someone actually was selling the flawless cut auto of Pat Tillman 101 from 2020 or 19, 21. I can't remember what year it was. Flawless auto, right? So I talked to him, came to a deal, said, okay, let's go for it. I did this all at night, not really sitting down, doing the math and everything. I was going to end up having to send a lot of stuff to consignment to pay for the part that I couldn't pay and stuff. So eventually down the road, I decided, I was like, I just can't get there. You know, it's one of those things that it would have been great grail to have, but it's just way out of the league. I could have eventually got there and everything, but I was just like, I don't want to get too tied up into it. I have a lot of stuff I was going to send to consignment, and I was going to deplete my inventory a lot. I just didn't want to do it. So I didn't feel right. Messaged him before the weekend and said, hey, I'm going to have to back out of the deal. I'm sorry, you know, and everything else. Like, I just can't get there. He tried to work with me. I just was already in my mindset. It probably wasn't going to be meant to be. So, of course, I was down in the dumps. I was just like, crap, there goes the grail. I mean, he only has like 6 to 8. I can't remember exactly. Guaranteed cut autos and products from National Treasures, Flawless, Leaf products and stuff like that. He doesn't have that many. So, and on top of that, he doesn't have a lot of signed stuff, period, out there, right? I was down in the dumps, whatever, and then a couple of my friends actually contacted me and said, hey, have you seen this on Golden? So I was just like, what, you know? And sure enough, sent me a link, and it wasn't one of those cut autos, of course, because it's hard to find all the other ones. I saw one sold last year, one of the cut autos. It was from Opulence. Is that what it's called? Whatever the big thick Panini product was, cut auto, sold for like $3,000 in December time frame. Nuts. Like, that price range is crazy for Pat Tillman auto. He doesn't have that many. So after a lot of the individuals contacted me and stuff, I was like, let's try to win this, see what I can do. I already had some money to set aside for the cut. Let's now focus that towards this. And I end up getting, from Golden Auctions, Pat Tillman, a true American hero. Hopefully it can. Autographed 16 by 20. The whole thing 16 by 20. This is, of course, I think, our autographs right there. It is certified by JSA. Comes with the certification. Already framed, nasty. I can't believe I have this, honestly. So this is incredible. This is gonna be in my future man cave, which we're currently in the process getting approved to get built. Gonna be on the walls next to so much other stuff. It's gonna be on the walls next to another goat. And a lot of people have never seen this, so I wanted to show it side by side because it kind of like matches almost a little bit. This one's a little bit bigger. These are going to be on my wall. Look at this. This is Michael Jordan game used floor from Chicago. Has the Bulls logo certified, and it was from the game used upper deck certification. Only numbered out of 100. These are two of my masterpieces from my man cave now. This is incredible. You know, this is a little bit smaller, but how many times have you seen an actual autograph of Pat Tillman? My PC next to one of the GOAT of all sports in my eyes. This is gonna be great. Love it, baby. So yeah, that came in today. Super pumped. Just won it the other day. And super fast shipping. Shout out to Golden for shipping fast. UPS pretty much like overnight getting here. But yeah, like I said, crazy. Crazy mail day, right? But that's all I have. Thank you guys if you made it this far. 24 minutes is a long time to sit here and watch someone just talk about things and stuff like that. I appreciate every single one of you that do. Follow me on Instagram. I'm more active on there. You can message me on there because I don't know where messages went in YouTube. I don't even think they're around anymore. We can talk it up. Hopefully you can get in the area. Preemptively, January, end of January, I'm probably going to be at Culture Collision. Wanted to be at Burbank this weekend. Could not cut it. Too much stuff, everything. Still, you know, living off of fucking the Nationals. So trying to get ready for some bigger future shows. So that's the biggest one down the road, I believe. Chantilly in October, I'll be there. Haven't been confirmed yet. I'm on the wait list. So I want to set up there, but if anyone's going to Chantilly, hopefully a lot of people are, say hi, see you there. But yeah, that's all I got for today. Hopefully I'll get some more content to you soon. Catch y'all later. Deuces.